Fox News pundit Jeanine Pirro attempted to defend former President Donald Trump by making a legal comparison between him and two notorious convicted fraudsters.
When Sam Bankman-Fried, who apparently conned something like $1 million or 1 million victims, his bond was $250 million. Bernie Madoff had 40,000 victims. His bond was $10 million. Donald Trump, no victims, $500 million. I mean, I don't know where those people from the other stations are learning the law or what they're talking about. But look, there's no harm, no foul. That's the end of it.
This is Fox News' legal mind. She was a judge. Oof. Okay, so there's a couple of ridiculous arguments in here. First off, the cases are completely different. Donald Trump was found liable for fraud in civil court. Madoff and Bankman-Fried were tried in criminal court. Again, there's some different rules when it comes to civil versus criminal. Okay, now Trump has to pay a bond if he wants to appeal the civil judgment against him. That judgment originally was supposed to be 120% of the, you know, of the amount, the judgment amount against him, as well as any interest. So that was like over $500 million because the fraud he was found liable of was about $355 million. So that's a lot of fraud. Proportional, right? So that makes sense. Now, Bankman-Fried and Madoff, remember, their bond wasn't to appeal. Their bond was to try to get them to stay out of prison during the trial, because that's what that bond is for in a criminal case. Not only that, no prison time for Trump, no possibility of prison time for Trump because it's a civil trial. And if he had not been able to afford the judgment, then he wouldn't have gone to prison or stayed in prison, which people that, again, if you can't afford bond in a criminal case, you have to stay in prison until your trial. Whereas Donald Trump, once again, no possibility of being in prison. This was also that he could appeal his judgment. That's it. Now, if he didn't pay that judgment, the city would have begun paying his, taking his assets to pay that off, right? Now, that's no longer on the table since the appeals court lowered his bond to about $175 million. It's still a significant amount of money to come up with. And put some stipulations, or I should say they kept the stipulations on being able to borrow from any New York City financial institution. But this makes it a lot easier for Trump to be able to get that bond money. So, and gave him an additional 10 days. So that's that argument, okay? The difference between civil and criminal cases, which again, somebody who's a judge and a lawyer, or ex-judge, I should say, should probably know, okay? So let's get to the harm, though. So she says, "Wash, no victims. No victims? What are you talking about?" One of the biggest refrains from the right on Donald Trump's fraud trial is that this was a victimless crime. Again, Trump says this, Pirro says it, everybody says it, right? Even now, though, Even a now retired Deutsche Bank executive also testified on Donald Trump's behalf, saying, "Hey, you know, we made it through all right. No victims, right?" Okay, but just because bank executives turned a blind eye to Donald Trump's fraud doesn't mean there weren't any victims of it. Trump getting these loans he was not qualified for ultimately reduced resources available for other more honest borrowers. But you could say Donald Trump, not exactly an honest borrower. Anybody who played by the rules got screwed over. There's still a lot of people who try to play by the rules, okay, in order to, you know, get loans by actually being honest in their financial disclosures, their assets and liabilities, you know, in order to get what they can afford and what they think they deserve, okay? Those people get screwed over. Now, that message, of course, that gets sent here when they let someone like Trump do what he did is go ahead and lie and cheat in order to get more favorable terms as long as you're wealthy enough. We're not going to hold you accountable. And in the process, we're gonna punish honest people so we can get some short-term profits. That's it. These bank executives were willing to overlook Donald Trump's fraud so they could get their whale and get a fat quarterly bonus. That's what that is. And that hurts the banking system overall. It's the same kind of dishonest, short-term profit-seeking behavior that eventually leads us down the road to a financial collapse. I mean, that's it. That's the kind of behavior. Risk taking risky bets on people that should not have taken those loans. All right. And so this just reinforces the fact that no one should trust our financial system anymore because it is deeply corrupt. And if Donald Trump is able to escape accountability on this, it could show people that our system is not fixable, which could lead to even more problems down the road. Fraud like Trump's is a symptom of a bigger problem, of a bigger sickness, and he shouldn't be protected just because certain people like his politics. Now, Juliet Jeske, the journalist who authors the Substack newsletter Decoding Fox News, pointed out that, again, Trump is not being criminally charged in the civil trial case. The amount that he had put up was not a bond to keep him out of prison. This is embarrassing for a lawyer and a former judge. Jeske's followers agreed, one saying, the bar is low with Pirro. That's MSNBC anchor Katie Fang. Tara Dublin added, Judge Jeanine needs to stop licking the walls that the box of wine she lives in. I don't know if there's any truth to the rumors that she's always drunk, but I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if her and Rudy Giuliani were constantly three sheets to the wind all the time. She just seems like it, okay? One person says, she is probably drunk again. And another said, I think she knows they're intentionally misleading their viewers to cause outrage and trigger a dopamine release to keep said users addicted to their content. I have to thank Jean-Luc Potcard for that. That's a pretty good comment. And it's true. I mean, for a lot of Fox News hosts, that's exactly how it works. That's the whole point, to keep people, keep right-wingers hooked on this content by making them constantly outraged. All right. Now, with Jeanine Pirro, everybody knew she was crazy. The producers knew she was crazy, but kept her and even promoted her because she was giving the audience exactly what they wanted. In fact, this is Justin Wells, Fox host Tucker Carlson's executive producer back when he was actually at Fox News, okay? As well as Jerry Andrews, who was Pirro's executive producer on her Saturday show. They said, quote, they took her off because she was being crazy. Optics are bad, but she is crazy. That was Justin Wells. Andrews just likewise described her as, quote unquote, nuts. Simple as that. Now, that's why Pirro received no repercussions for promoting election conspiracy theories that led to Fox News having to settle with Dominion Voting Systems for $787 million. So now, first, they kind of yanked her off the air for a little bit because she had on people like Sidney Powell, but they started to lose viewership to Newsmax and other places. So they put her back on and then eventually gave her a nice big promotion from having her Saturday show to being on The Five, which is their Fox News' weekday show. And now she enjoys the highest ratings in cable news, where she just sits there and lies the entire time and defends Donald Trump shamelessly. Now, funny enough, the Fox producers and executives all knew she was crazy. And yet, at the same time, right, they're saying, oh, you're crazy, crazy for promoting these things. They weren't doing anything about, you know, her actually doing that. They were, again, they promoted her and they were actively going after Fox News, the news site employees, for doing factual reporting and counteracting the lies. So that's what's going on here. Okay. The audience wants the stuff, the crazy. Fox News wants to keep the audience. And so look, that's what they're going to do. They're going to continue to give the audience what they want, regardless of whether or not it is true, especially if it's not true, as long as the audience wants it. To hell with facts, logic, and reason. And they found the perfect person in Jeanine Pirro to do that. Absolutely shameless. Whether or not she's shameless or legitimately insane and actually believes these things doesn't really matter, because the effect is the same. And so people like her will say anything to make Donald Trump, the person who keeps somehow getting every break in the world, despite committing massive amounts of fraud, a victim.